Sorry if any of y'all hear snoring when this video is going on. I have my dog Ollie sitting in my lap for this video.
Say hello. Say hi. I'm sleepy, right?
Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Averie, and today I have a different kind of video. I'm going to be doing a little bit of a life update, and I'm going to be shouting out some booktubers that I think need to be shouted out. First, I just want to say that I plan to do a Q&A soon. I've never done one before. If any of y'all have any questions, be sure to leave them down below in the comments, or you can send them to me via Twitter. My link to my Twitter is in my bio down below. So I want to talk about the things that I'm currently reading just right off the bat. Physically, I am reading Cold Hearted Rake by Lisa Kleypas. I'm only on page like 30, and I started it, I want to say maybe a week ago. I'm actually buddy reading this with Kayla from Literature Reads, but I told her I'm having a rough time at the moment health-wise, and I'll get into that later. That's what I'm physically reading. I haven't picked it up in over a week, so I don't know what I'm gonna do about it. So we'll see about this, but this is a historical romance book. I am also listening to Forever With You by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I'm reading this through my Libby app through the library, and this is the fifth book in the like Wait For You series. I'm gonna talk about the series in general in more detail in my April wrap-up, because I've read the first five books in April. But this is a contemporary romance series. It's also around people who are around the age of college, so I really enjoyed that because I don't really read a lot of books about people my age. So I'm really enjoying this one and just this series as a whole. And lastly, on my ebook, I am currently reading Barbarian's Rescue by Ruby Dixon. I'm finally continuing on with this series, and I'm flying through the rest of these books because I don't have a lot of energy to physically read a book right now. So reading on my phone has just been like so easy, and I've been loving it. They're all free if you have Kindle Unlimited, so I've been taking advantage of that and trying to finish the Ice Planet Barbarian series. I'm actually really enjoying this series. I just think it's a fun series that just gets my mind off of the real world, and it's all I can ask from a book. So I'm actually really enjoying this series, even though they're not the best written books I've ever read, but I am trash for these couples. I am also rewatching Once Upon a Time at the moment. I am on, I believe, season 2, and it's been a while since I've done a rewatch, like years, so I am really excited for what the rest of the series holds. I don't remember a lot, actually, and it was one of my favorite shows growing up, so I just love Emma and Hook so much. It's like one of the ultimate OTPs for me, and I love them, and I love watching them. But anyways, enough about what I'm reading and watching. I need to talk about why I haven't been that present on my channel as of late. If you've been keeping up with my Twitter, you might have known that earlier last week, I ended up blacking out, passing out while I was at work. And that has happened one other time a month ago. My family and I have come to the conclusion that something else might be wrong up with me. Me blacking out and like not remembering where I am and stuff like that has happened at least, I want to say, 5 times since January. 2 of them have been during the day and the other 3 have been at night. I've woken up in my sleep and I wake up with a ringing in my ears, and I have no idea where I am, who I am. It takes me a couple minutes, but luckily when I'm home in my bed, my dog's with me and she helps me come out of that state. It's kind of really hard when it happens in public during the day. After that incident last week, I had to go get some blood work done to figure out what was wrong with me, because for a while there, my parents just thought it was a side effect to one of the other disorders that I have. I have something called postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. It's a mouthful. We call it POTS for short, but I have to say that long word or else people are gonna think pot, which it's not. It's called POTS. Basically, that's where my blood doesn't regulate normally, and blood likes to pool to my feet, so I'm fatigued and dizzy, and I faint very easily if I overexert myself. My heart rate is naturally really high, like higher than other people's. Like jogging across my yard would bring it to maybe like 160, 170. So I have to monitor and regulate that. So me passing out and blacking out we thought that was a side effect to the disorder that I already have. But I kept telling my parents, I'm like, there's something else wrong. I wasn't doing anything. I was sitting on the couch watching the kids that I nanny, and I literally was doing nothing, and I just woke up on the floor. Normally, when I black out or pass out from my POTS, I overexert myself in a certain way. I knew something else was wrong, so we went and got some blood work done. So we found out that I am iron deficient. I don't have a lot of iron in my system. It's way lower than normal. And we also found out that my blood cells, my red blood cells that hold like the oxygen for the body, are way smaller than a normal person's. So that's probably why I'm blacking out, is I'm not getting enough oxygen to my brain. So I could either have anemia, a blood disorder, or both. So I am seeing a doctor later this week to figure out what's going on. Yeah, I've been very, very, very tired as of late. I've always been like a tired and fatigued person, but it's been worse than it normally is. And maybe we're just coming to the realization that now, since Avery has been tired basically her whole life, that she's actually been anemic this whole time. You know what I mean? So I've been very fatigued lately, been very tired. I haven't had the energy to really read anything except on my phone, like an ebook before bed. That's what I've been doing for the past week, and I haven't been reading all that much like I normally do. I haven't been posting any videos because getting ready and putting on makeup and having like a little, not a script, but like a little guide for my videos, getting all the books that I need for a video, setting up the equipment for a video, standing up for that long for a video. Just thinking about it makes me so tired, and I end up wanting to take a nap instead. So I haven't been making videos. This is the best that I can do right now, just sitting here in a chair with my dog in my lap talking to y'all. Since I've been so tired, I've had no creative energy whatsoever. I only know that I can do a wrap up. That's like the thing that I know that I can do. So I haven't been posting anything. I haven't really been watching all that much either. You know when I've watched one of your videos, because I always comment on my fellow booktubers' channels. I always comment on their videos. I love doing that. It's one of my favorite things to do. But like even doing that takes so much of my time and so much energy from me. And it's ridiculous. But I want to get back to the swing of things and hopefully seeing a doctor at the end of the week will help me with that. But anyway, speaking of watching booktubers, I wanted to shout some people out today because I didn't want to just make it all about me and my little struggles in my life. I wanted to spread the love for booktubers out there that I'm really enjoying, that I think deserve more praise. These are either small booktube channels, like really small, like under 400 subscribers, I want to say, or they're fairly new. I'm sorry if I pronounce anyone's names or channel names wrong. I'm so sorry. First we have, I believe her name is Aramus. I'm so sorry if I pronounce your name wrong, but she goes by Moose on YouTube from the channel Aramus, and she is such a wonderful, nice person. Like I said on Twitter how I'm looking for more booktube Twitter friends, and she immediately gave me her number. She's currently reading, I think, Pride and Prejudice still, and I love that book, even though I think I accidentally spoiled it for her, which I am so sorry again. But she loves bargain shopping, which I love because I love bargain shopping for books, and so I always learn about new books from her, from the little bookstores or little sales that she goes to or sees online. So yeah, I totally recommend her channel. Next is one of my best friends here on booktube. We have Hannah from Being the Bookologist. I am so surprised that Hannah doesn't have way more followers than she does. I believe she only has like 200, like 15 maybe. And I think she deserves like way more. She's been on booktube, I think, I want to say around a year. I think she's been on here for a while, and I just feel like she needs more love, and her videos are so great, and she reads such great books that like I don't understand why people don't go watch more of her videos. But yes, I love Hannah. We read basically a lot of the same stuff. She loves her YA and her romance, and I love that too. I just love talking to her. I feel like she's just an amazing person with great book recommendations, and I also have to say, like, her thumbnails are some of the best thumbnails like ever, because she like draws her own thumbnails, which are super cool. Please, please, please go check out Hannah's channel. Next, we have a newbie for y'all. Her name is Deborah from B Books. I think she maybe started around 2 months ago or a month ago, I want to say. But yeah, I stumbled across her channel and she is just a wonderful human being. She's from Italy. I just love hearing her opinions on books. I think they're so original and so her, and I think she's being very honest with how she reviews books, and I love it. And I also love her Bookstagram. She takes some great pictures of books and I love looking at them. I know she reads YA. I believe she also reads some adult books, but mostly adult fantasy. I know she reads fantasy books. So if you're into all that, be sure to go check out her channel. Next we have Amy from Book Girl Abroad. Amy changed her channel name, I want to say like a month or two ago maybe. She recently moved to Germany and thought that she would incorporate like travel with her book-ish channel, so she changed her channel to Book Girl Abroad so she could add both in there, which I think is amazing. I think that she reads like a wide range of books. I know she reads fantasy books, she reads young adult books, she reads romance books. I've gotten some great romance books recommendations from her, which of course I love because romance books are everything to me. I just gotta say, she is one of the prettiest, most beautiful human beings I've ever seen in my life. And she is so sweet and nice. She's amazing. And I think everyone should go check her channel out for sure. Next we have Katie from Book Bliss. Katie, I love Katie. She is really funny and sweet and just original and unapologetically herself, and I just love her for that. She is a fellow Sarah J. Maas lover, a fellow Throne of Glass lover. She rereads Throne of Glass like so often and I love it. She posts so many videos. I don't know how she does it. She just does. I wish that I could post as much as her, but I don't know how she does it. I think she posts like 3 times a week, maybe twice a week. I don't know. That's a lot to me. I praise her for that. Oh my God. I just think all of her videos are great. She has great ideas. I love watching her tag videos and I think she's just so nice. And yeah, I love her and I hope that y'all love her too. And go check out her channel like right now. Next, we have another small booktuber. We have Jen from Bookish Jen. I found her channel, I want to say like a year ago, and I just fell in love with her channel. I think she is a great person and she reads some great books and she puts great insight into the books that she reads and talks about. Her favorite book is Fangirl. It's right there next to me, and she talks about it all the time, and I love that because I love seeing her fangirl over fangirl, because I love that book a lot, and y'all need to go check her out so you can fangirl with her together. Next we have Lucy from Crescent Pages. I love Lucy. She's also great and very present on Twitter, so go check out her Twitter too. So Lucy is a channel I never thought that I would really enjoy, and that is because she doesn't like romance in books. She's not a fan of them. I have yet to hear about a book that she loved the romance in. But I never thought that I would enjoy a channel like that, but I do. I love learning about books that aren't romance heavy or don't even have any romance in them, because it's like a refresher book to me. And yes, I love my romance books and I love romance in general, but I feel like I also need like a palate cleanser every now and then. I think Lucy talks about some books that are great for that, and she also reads some classics that I really love learning about because I love classics. And I just feel like I can always trust her opinion with a book because she is so brutally honest in her opinions, and I love it. I can always trust her with the way she feels about a book. I totally recommend going to see her channel because I can always get great book recommendations from her. Next, we have Haley Mitz. I believe that's how you pronounce her name. I'm so sorry, Haley. She is a newbie. She started her channel around 2 months ago, and I saw her BookTube newbie tag and like loved her vibe and how she presented herself, and she seems super passionate about books, and I really loved that. I think her favorite book is Skyward by Brandon Sanderson, I believe. Please correct me if I'm wrong, Haley. I think she said that at one point. She talks about it so passionately that I feel like I need to read it like now. Even though I don't have the book, I hope to get it soon, and I always, always, always look forward to her videos, so be sure to go check out her channel. Next, we have another one of my besties here on BookTube. We have Mindy from Mindy's Book Journey. Mindy has been on here, I want to say, like, as long as I have. I love her channel. I don't read a lot of the books that she reads, but I love to hear her insight on the books that she reads. I just love to hear about how passionate she is. She has so many books, and she reads so much that I just love to hear about it. She reads a lot of sci-fi and fantasy, more so in the adult genre. She reads a lot of horror, which isn't my thing. Like, I don't really read all that much adult anything except for romance books. So I love to hear about new books from her, and I do occasionally find out a new adult book that I totally need to get on the train for from her. I don't read horror or mystery books, but she does. But I love to hear her opinions on them. So be sure to go check out Mindy's channel. She's amazing and deserves so much more praise. Next is Steph from Neffa Entertainment. I love Steph so much. She became a booktube newbie, I believe, earlier this year. I love her videos. I always look forward to her videos. She is like so funny and beautiful and just fantastic. And I love her channel so much. She's almost to 200 subscribers. So please, 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 please go and check her out. And lastly, we have one of my other friends here on booktube. We have Matt from This Is Me. He is, I believe, 9 away from 100 subscribers. And I feel like y'all need to go give him some love, please, because he's almost there at 100. He isn't a sole booktube channel. He talks about musicals and just life in general, movies, I believe a TV shows. He's just an all-around, I want to say kind of like a fandom-based channel for the fandoms that he loves. He talks about some great books on there. He does some great tag videos, and I just love his personality and think he's a great human being, and I feel like he deserves way more praise as well. So there you have it. That was a little life update and little booktuber shout out for y'all. I hope you go and check out all these YouTubers. They are great. This obviously isn't every booktuber that I love. I have subscribed to way more booktubers than I can count. Maybe I'll do another one of these videos in the future. Just because you didn't see your name or someone else's name on here doesn't mean that I don't watch your videos or don't think you deserve more praise. I think that everyone deserves more praise. And please be patient with me in the near future. I don't know what my schedule's gonna be like with posting videos, and we'll see how this goes. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see y'all soon with a new video. Bye!